Hey, it's Thomas here, and today we're doing a quick review on the Kessil A360X Tuna Blue. If you're looking for an LED light that is super simple to set up for your specific reef, has what is widely considered to be the best shimmer available, closely resembling metal halides, is a long-standing favorite of the BRS team with a spectrum that is nearly identical to the gold standard ATI Blue Plus and is a part of Ryan's new platinum standard for the BRS360, then check out the Kessil A360X Tuna Blue. I mean, thousands of reefers have been growing awesome looking corals under Kessils for a very long time. Quite the resume. There is no doubt that choosing the right light for our reef tanks can make a tremendous difference with coral health, growth, and coloration. Finding a light with optimal spectrum, PAR intensity, and distribution that is easy to set up and get right the first time while still providing flexibility and control is the ultimate goal for any reefer. Kessil is one of the titans of LED lighting for aquariums. They began their reef lighting journey back in 2009 and have spent the last decade helping many a reefer achieve the tank of their dreams filled with amazing looking corals, dramatic metal halide like shimmer, in a tiny package with their unique dense matrix LED spotlight approach to reef lighting. The A360X Tuna Blue is one of, if not the favorite when it comes to LEDs at BRS, due to its wide spectrum offering using Kessil logic to make sure your corals always get what they need while allowing you to tune the light visually to your preference with simple dials on the light for both color and intensity, making it one of the easiest plug and play LED options out there, while still being able to provide more complex control if desired via Kessil's Wi-Fi dongle and app. But most importantly, because it has proven time and time again to reliably grow stunning show quality coral colonies. In the box, you'll find the A360X Tuna Blue, the power adapter, AC adapter cable, DC extension cable, hanging ring, metal screw hooks, and hanging brackets. The A360X is a 90 watt LED fixture and compared to its predecessor has a much sleeker form factor thanks to the new cooling design, being much shorter and only a touch wider while still having all of the same fantastic mounting options. So if the included hanging ring or brackets and hooks aren't for you, the gooseneck and A-series mounting arms are great options. If you have an Aquatic Life hybrid fixture, there are also brackets specifically tailored to the new A360X that you can pick up. Personally, I find that the A-series mount is the nicest. It's really, really light while being super robust. It also has an internal cord routing channel, so you don't have to look at the cables or anything hanging around it, which is really, really sleek. Holds the light at a perfect 90 degree angle, which is really nice, especially if you're gonna have a few of them on there. They can all look absolutely perfect. Goosenecks can be a little bit tough. Yeah, just a really solid mounting option. When it comes to spectrum, the A360X has one of the widest spectrum offerings available and comes incredibly close to the reefing gold standard, the ATI Blue Plus, with a very wide band in the blue spectrum between 400 and 500 nanometers, while also including a true near UV peak around 380 nanometers, coming together to generously cover the essential peaks for chlorophyll and carotenoid production, which ultimately means excellent coral growth and coloration. The A360X also has big improvements over its predecessor when it comes to showing off coral fluorescence with a lot more color pop thanks to that wide blue spectrum and splash of near UV. Kessil's dense matrix LED array tucked behind a single optic continues to produce a very even spread of light, especially for a spotlight style fixture, along with what is still regarded by most as the best shimmer in the industry and the closest replacement to that classic metal halide look. What's new with the A360X is its ability to go from its standard wide 130 degree beam angle down to a 55 degree beam angle with the use of the optional narrow beam reflector that clips on magnetically in seconds. No tools, just like that. Making it one of the few, if not the only LED fixture with more than one optimal mounting height and ability to penetrate effectively in both shallow and deep tanks. Out of the box, the A360X has onboard control through two knobs, one for intensity and the other for color, which makes setting it up for use with a timer extremely easy. Set the color knob to what looks best to your eye and then adjust the intensity to the needs of your corals. Kessil's logic makes sure that no matter where the color knob lands, your corals are going to receive the spectrum that they need in order to thrive, which means there's no way to get it wrong. The A360X is also compatible with the Kessil app when paired with the optional Wi-Fi dongle, giving you access to advanced features for spectrum, custom schedules, moonlighting, and acclimation modes. You actually get 3 extra points of control for dialing in your preferred spectrum. In addition to the white and blue channels, you can individually control the red, green, and violet channels, which is great. Personally, I wish Kessil had Wi-Fi and app control as a standard feature like most LED options out there, rather than it being an add-on, but I can see the appeal of only paying for a single Wi-Fi dongle that can control up to dozens of these lights linked together with K-Link cables instead of, say, having to pay for a Wi-Fi chip that's built into every single light that's gonna bump the price up. It makes sense, especially if you're gonna put this on a digital timer and just use the knobs that are on top, because that is so easy to do. Yeah, I get it. Now, beyond the specs and features, what makes this light a favorite at BRS is the very simple fact that it produces awesome results. Kessil lights have been used on many BRS tanks, including the BRS160, and are a key ingredient of Ryan's gold standard of lighting when paired with T5s. And they've performed so well, so consistently, Ryan's gonna be using them as a part of his new platinum standard of lighting, pairing them up with XHO Reef Brights instead of T5s for his BRS360 build. So that says a ton. If you're wondering about that narrow beam reflector and whether or not you need it, it's going to depend a lot on how high you want to mount your Kessil or have to, depending on your setup, or how deep your tank is. To find out exactly how it's going to affect your part and spread, Randy has an amazing video that goes over just that topic. You can check it out right here. By the end of it, you will know for certain whether or not that narrow beam reflector is something you're going to want to look at. It does a really good job. Like, remarkably good job, but only if you need to mount it higher or have a super deep tank. So check it out.